Okay, good morning students. I am here to teach you C++. My name is Neelam and we start with basic concepts of C++ and then goes to the large programs. Now first, I know you all have read there about C language. Then if we study initially C++, we found there are very less difference between C and C++ because both are more or less same languages. There is only you will find that there is a difference in writing printf statement and scanf statements, and C in C out the equivalent statements are very easy to write. But as the size of the program grows, we find there are lots of difference between C and C++. The basic difference between C and C++ is their approach in solving the programs, in solving a particular problem. While C use structured programming approach, C++ use object-oriented programming approach. So what is object-oriented programming approach and why we are so much obsessed with these objects? Actually, objects are the real representation of our world. Whatever we see in the world, we store them in the form of objects in our mind. For example, if you talk about a car, so you immediately came with a picture in your mind. A picture comes in your mind and you can see that it has some vehicle in which the four person can sit. It has four tires, it has some driver seat. So same way, if we talk about a table, you immediately think about a picture which has four legs and a platform to write something or to put some objects on that also. So these are the real pictures of the objects. Every object has some properties and some functions. So as in the real world, we actually talk about the objects, these approaches easily can be used in the programming methodologies also. Structured programming approach is simple, but it is unable to handle the large set of programs. Now we will talk about C++. Now C++ is a middle level programming language that runs on a variety of platforms such as DOS, Windows, Mac and Unix. So first thing is, what is middle level language? In middle level language, we all have read about the low level language and high level language. Where low level language is binary language, like a language which use binary patterns, pattern of 1 and 0s, or assembly language which use symbols, and a high level language is English like language. Then what about the middle level language? Actually C++ is a high level language which can use the feature of a low level language. That's why we call it a middle level programming language. Here we can access the features which generally a low level language can access. So, and at the same time, we can use English-like words in our language. So, it is easy to write, learn, and then debug. While the other advantages of C++ is, it can run on different type of platforms, such as we can run it on DOS, on Windows, and of course on Unix. We all know that some portion of Unix is written in C. Next, C++ gives programmer a high level of control over system resources and memory. As I have just told you that C++ has access to the low level programming features. So that's why it has more control over system resources and memory, which a normal high level language cannot have. Now, C++ is a general purpose language. Actually, we can develop different type of applications in a C++ language. That's why it is known as general purpose language. And it was created by a Danish scientist whose picture you can see in the first PowerPoint presentation. In 1979, he began work with C with classes. Actually, he starts with C languages and he want to extend the capability of C. So he used concept of classes. And when the language of C is modified enough, it became known as C++. So why he decided to extend the capabilities of C? Because it is because of his own experience. When he was doing his PhD, he found that the Simula has the features which are very helpful in developing large programs, while it was very slow. But BCPL is very fast and it is very suitable for low level programming, but its capabilities are limited. So he started to extend the capabilities of BCPL, which further became converted into the C language. So he starts with C, and there he includes classes, the features of Simula in C language, and it becomes a very powerful language. So C was chosen because it was general purpose, fast, portable and widely used. Because C was a very popular language at that time, so he used C as a base language and then start extending its feature by using features of other languages like ALGOL and ADA. So over the time, when C is extended very much, so it is became known as C++. So why we use C++? What are the various features of C++? Who makes it so popular? First thing, user friendly. Anything which you want, we use, we want it user friendly, so that we can easily use it, we can easily learn it. So C++ is very user-friendly. We can easily learn, we can easily use, and then we can easily debug a C++ program. So if we find, if we create or if we put any error in a C++ program, we can easily debug, we can easily modify it. Next is portability. Portability is, it can run on different platforms. I have already told you that a program written in C++ can be written on Windows, DOS, Unix, etc. without very little modifications. So it supports different hardware. This is very important features, because if you write a program on one platform, it is very difficult to run it on another platform. But in C++, it's very easy. Next is applications. Well, C++ can handle different type of application. We can write different type of programs in it, like we can write an operating system. For example, we all know Unix is written in C, then graphical user interfaces, and then we can write embedded system programs in C++ easily. Then reusability. C++ is an object-oriented programming language. So with the help of objects, actually we divide our programs in different parts. And if we want to use a part in another program, it is very easy to use the program in another parts. That's why reusability feature allow us to use the same code in different programs, and thus lowers our manpower and our development cost. Next is similarity. It is very similar to other programs. So due to its similarity, we can easily learn C++. So if one knows C, he can easily switch to C++. And it is also very much similar to Java. So when you learn C++, you can easily learn Java. Next is very powerful language. It is very fast and efficient language. The program written in C++ language execute very fast and very efficient, so it takes very less amount of memory for its execution. Next is low level features. It has very many low level features like shift operator, AND operator, and here in C++ we have register storage classes. With the help of this storage classes, we can easily manipulate the registers in C++ in CPU. Because as we can use the CPU registers, the speed of the program execution becomes very fast. Next is application of C programming, where we can use the C++ programs. We can, I have already told you, we can develop large number of different varieties of C++ programs. So C++ is most commonly used programming language. We can use it in almost every area of software development. So one is, first is computer programming. If you want to teach students about a basic language features, we can use C++ because it is very easy to learn and very easy to teach. And all above all this, it has very fast speed and computational efficiencies. So we can easily develop programs in C++. It can also use in research work. Next is application software development. We can develop application software in it as well as system software. Like we can use system software, like we can develop operating system, we can develop GUI. So all we have seen that the Windows, Unix and some part of Firefox, Chrome are written in C++. So C++ is very efficient language and it can use to develop different type of softwares. Next is programming languages development. We can develop different languages by using C++, like Java, JavaScript, Perl, games development. Next is, see, as we all know, C++ is extremely fast. So it is very suitable to write the game programs, because in game we need efficient program and we need a greater control over the hardware, which is possible in C++. So we use C++ for the development of game. Next is embedded system. C++ is used in the medical and engineering system where we need the embedded system. For example, for the MRI machine in the medical field, we need the software that can be inserted in the hardware, because they are the specialized type of software, so that they can work efficiently. So these type of system can also be developed by using C++. Next, we talk about the object-oriented programming feature of C++. We have discussed why we use C++, the different applications of C++, but how these different applications can be feasible in C++. So its primary reason is that it is an object-oriented programming language. What is this object-oriented programming approach? See, in generally, in starting, we use structured programming approach to develop a program. Structured programming approach is very helpful in developing small programs, simple programs. In the starting, we actually don't use any type of approach. There was no concept of a program methodologies. The program did not use any approach. The user developed the program according to its needs. They don't think about a particular structure of a program. So they use plenty of go-to statements, which makes very difficult to understand the program logic. Over the time, when the sizes of program starts increasing, there was a need to develop a proper methodologies for the development of a program. So structured programming approach was developed and we start using that in our programming languages. Structured programming approach is actually a programming approach in which we have a clear defined logic, and here we have all the statements with a particular reason. Moreover, we develop our program in different pieces. That pieces are known as modules. So it became very easy to develop program in structured programming approach. Then as the size of programs in became larger and larger, so it became tough to develop those programming structured programming approach. So there was a need to develop another programming approach, and then the concepts of objects evolved. Although the concept of objects was not new, but it was understood, it was taken in the programming after a need of a language where we can develop large programs. So in the objects we actually imitate the real world, or we actually represent the real world more clearly, more easily, because in real world also we use objects, we use the concepts of objects. What are the objects? I have already told you, objects are the things which we can differentiate from the others. Like we can differentiate between a table and a car, because both have the different properties, both have the different functions. So we understand and remember the things in terms of their properties and their functions. These same features we use in object-oriented programming approach. There also we understand or we store the things in the form of their properties and their functions. These properties are very particular to every object, and these functions can be operated on those properties. So primary reason of developing C++ programming language was to include object-oriented features of the C programming language, which is also one of the most powerful programming language. As we have already discussed, C++ is superset of C. It started with the C language, and in order to extend the properties of C language, the scientists include object features and classes features in C language, and after it became developed in a different approach and it became known as C++. The foundation of the pure object-oriented programming is to create an object that has properties and functions just like real world. I have already told you, real-life objects like car, tables, students, even students is also an object. You people have different roll numbers, name, your address, and then you people have to deposit your fine, your fees. So these fees, fine are the functions. They can be performed on your data or your results, your marks. While designing C++ modules, we visualize whole words in the form of objects. For example, a chair is an object which has certain properties such as color, four legs, and a platform to sit. Its function is to sit. So there are few standard concepts that form the foundation of object-oriented program. Well, why we are so much obsessed with object-oriented programs? It's because of the feature of classes. Now, we can discuss the simple languages. While simple languages, I have already told you that traditional languages did not follow any particular approach. There the program are randomly returns. So what are the drawbacks in those languages? These languages, there are no reuse facility. We cannot reuse the existing written code. Second, they use numerous jump statement, which could not be explained on the basis of some valid logic. Next, there are all the variables were globals. There was no concept of local variable as you have read in C. Moreover, it was very difficult to maintain a long, large program in those type of languages. So we came with the concept of structured programming approach. I told you, structured programming approach based on the decomposition of the program or the problem in smaller pieces, or you can say in smaller solutions. For example, you want to arrange a party for your birthday, but you need you will divide the whole process into smaller processes like buying a dress, second choosing a venue, then deciding the menu, about the budget. So these are the different tasks which you have to perform in order to celebrate your birthday. And the details about how these functions can be performed can be discussed on a later stage. So in structured programming approach, we divide our program in simple parts, in simple portions. First, we decide about these simple pieces, how to make them or how to find their solutions. We develop our program in smaller pieces, and then these smaller pieces are packed together in a program so that we can get the overall solution of our problem. Now, by dividing the program into smaller pieces, we make our work very easy. And these different pieces are known as modules, and these modules can be developed independently, and the module developed in a particular program can be used in another program if the another program to have the same problem. So here we can reuse the code. Now again, by using different modules, we use the concept of abstraction. Like when we decide how to celebrate our birthday, we divide it into different tasks: buying a dress, then for a menu, then menu. Here we hide the detail how we buy the dress, how we decide the menu. We just talk about the different functions which we have to perform. This is known as abstraction. Abstraction is something where we look at the program without concern about its internal detail. Here we talk about what to do. We don't talk about how to perform a task. The question is what to do. When we understand what to do, after that we move to how to perform. So this abstraction is also used in structured programming approach. Now in this structured programming, we concentrate on doing things. We concentrate more on our process. We concentrate how can we solve our problem. We have two different things in our program. One is data and second is function. Like we have discussed, we have some properties and then we have some functions. So we have more emphasis on the process in a structured programming approach. We generally don't concentrate on data. Data is a secondary thing in structured programming approach. We don't think about the security of data. We don't think how to store the data. We don't think how we can perform various applications on a data. We think about our functions, our modules, our processes. So this emphasis is still in C. We use structured programming approach. There more concentration is on the development of program, on the functions of the program, on the solution of the program. But as the size of the programs increases, we find out that data is also equally important. We should concentrate on our data because there may be some problem when some user intentionally or unintentionally can operate on wrong data. For example, we take our college. Here we have students and teachers. These are two main objects. Now, students came here to study. We keep their record regarding their roll number, their name, their class, their fees, their marks, their exams, and teacher, we have their we keep information about their subjects, their expertise, and the functions for the teachers are to calculate their salary, while the function for the students are to calculate their fees, to prepare their results. But in case of structured programming approach, there is no control that we should not calculate the salary of a student. I mean, there is no control to prohibit our program or some user to calculate salary of a student. Intentionally or unintentionally, a user can do that and credit the amount in a student's account. But in object-oriented programming approach, we have a clear-cut approach where we bind the data and function in a single unit. Here, we can't do the fees of a student function can work on the data of a teacher, or a salary function of a teacher can work on a student's data. No, because here we have different objects. Like, we have an object of student where we define data of students and fees of students. Then we have another objects for the teacher. There we keep data about the teacher and salary program or salary function. In so here we bind data and function together, so that in any case we should not do the wrong computation. Here data is equally important as functions. So data became more important for us than functions. And you can see data of the companies is very important. Now today we can understand that data is equally or even more important than the process. Companies are specially trained. They don't sell your data, they don't use your data for the intended, for the purpose other than the intended, or they cannot disclose your data to others. So in C++, we give importance to data and we bind our data and functions in a single unit. And this single unit is class. Class is actually a unit in which we bind our data and our functions together. Next thing is object. Objects are actually instance of classes. We define as class student. Okay. When we define a class student, we are not talking about a particular student, any student. But when we talk about object, we are talking about a particular student. For example, we have said roll number 1001, name Rajesh. So here we are talking about a particular student, Rajesh, whose roll number is 1001. So object is an instance of class. Next, abstraction. Abstraction is also a feature of structured programming approach. And in object-oriented programs, we use abstraction in a detailed manner. Next is encapsulation. Encapsulation is binding of data and objects in a single unit. Now, inheritance and polymorphism are different other features of C++ which we will study in detail in due course of lectures. Today, my lecture ends here. Thank you. Hope you will understand general features of C++. In case you have any query, you can ask me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you.